Hello friends, today we'll see the new chapter, that is the fuel cell. In this one we'll see the three parts, but the first part is the basis of fuel cell. In this one we will discuss what is a fuel cell, what is the principle associated with it, and what is the one of the fuel cell operation we'll see. So let's begin with the presentation of today. So these are the contents: product introduction, fuel cell principle, fuel cell operation. So introduction. So what is a fuel cell? Cell, okay. So it's like a battery only, but there's a difference in the battery and the fuel cell that we'll see. So what is happening in a cell is the chemical energy is converted to the electrical energy. The same thing in fuel cell also, it is converting the chemical energy to the electrical energy without going to the intermediate stages of conversion. So if you compare with the fossil fuel type of generation from the coal, what happens? There's so many intermediate stages are there. You are not directly converting the chemical energy to the electrical. But here in a fuel cell, will be convert directly the chemical energy to the electrical energy. So what is the difference between the conventional types of energy sources for the electricity generation and the fuel cell that we want to see? So what are the advantages for the conventional oil, coal type of or oil type? What happens? There will be a CO2 generation is there, greenhouse effect is there. But here in a fuel cell, there is no such thing is there, less CO2 is there, or no miss emission is less. High efficiency, definitely so many stages are reduced, only one stage is there, so efficiency is higher. Yes, because turbines are not there, so it is silent and vibration free. And you know, the coal generation power plants required a large space, but here in a fuel cell is required very less space actually. Okay, but seeing a fuel cell is a not is open system, but for the proper operation, what we require some other equipments also, like air compressors, cooling and heat exchangers, and power electronic converters also. So to proper functioning, we require this whole thing for this fuel cell. So let's go for the principle of a fuel cell now. So fuel cell is an electrochemical device that combines the hydrogen and oxygen to produce electricity. And what are the byproducts in these reactions? Is the water and heat. Okay. With combining the hydrogen and oxygen, what the when reaction is taking place, you are getting the electricity, that is the electrons, and here it is electrons and water and heat. So this you can't see any harmful product byproducts. Okay, so that is why we are telling that less CO2 emissions are there. So what it is, it's a reverse electrolysis process actually what is happening. So similar to the battery, what is the difference between the battery and the fuel cell is fuel cell required a continuous supply. This fuel should be continuously supplied to the fuel, because whatever the H2 is there, that it should be continuously given to the fuel cell and O2 also. Okay, in a normal cell or in a battery, what we have seen, what is the internal structure? We have a two electrodes. Yes, same way here also, we have a two electrodes. Anode is positive and cathode is negative. We have a one electrolyte, okay, and a catalyst is there. Why the catalyst is usually used in a reaction, chemical reaction, to increase the reaction, to speed up the chemical process actually. For that purpose, so same thing is also used here. So simple one reaction is written here, that is 2H2 is combined with O2. So what you are getting? You are getting some water and electricity. Here electricity is electrons. See, if electricity means what is a current actually? It is a flow of electrons. When electrons flows in a circuit means definitely a current is there. That current definitely constitute to the electricity. Okay. So electricity, the electrons are generated plus heat. Okay, now the product we have one, two fuels are used. One is H2 and one is O2. So O2, okay, fine, we'll get. But how the H2 is produced? So two processes written here. One is the water electrolysis process, and there is a reforming fossil fuel. These are the two methods from where we can get the H2, hydrogen. Okay. But in a higher fuel temperature fuel cells, what is happening that we are directly giving the fossil fuel only, and inside only it is the H2 is formed and that is used. Okay, so that is for the higher temperature we are doing. Higher temperature fuel cell we are doing, what we are giving directly the fuel, fossil fuel only, and from inside only H2 is generated and that H2 is used for the fuel cell. So next one is the fuel cell operation. Here we have in this we have taken a one cell, that is the proton exchange membrane fuel cell, that is PEMFC. Okay, the short form is PEMFC. How it works? You can take any of the cell, but I have taken, you can take alkaline fuel cell also. We will see that whole fuel cell in detail with the reactions in the next video. So first we'll go for the figure. So this is the figure for the PEM. You can see what all things we are talking about actually. One is anode, the left side is anode, the fuel is in, fuel is out, anode is there, electrolyte is there, cathode is there, and then O2 is provided cathode side. Okay, now we talk about the reaction. H2 is there in the anode. What happens? H2 is separated, H2 molecule is separated, it forms H plus protons actually. So that is why it is proton membrane, proper proton exchange membrane, because proton is exchanged here through the electrolyte. Okay, the name comes from there only. So what happens this reaction, what happens? The electrons are there, but electrons can't cross the electrolyte. So what happens? That electrons are traveling to the external circuit. So definitely when wire is connected from anode to cathode and load is connected in between, so what happens? Electrons start flowing from the external circuit. So definitely current will flow. Electron flow means current flow. So this H2 is with O2 from the cathode side will react it again and it will form, and electrons coming from the back from the circuit reacts and forms the H2O. And then H2O with water you are getting output. So this is the reaction explanation we'll see in again by reading it. Hydrogen is supplied at the anode side, oxygen is supplied at the cathode side. Two reactant gases, the hydrogen and oxygen, flows in a supply channel of each other. There's a chamber only it's given actually. So and diffuses to the gas diffusion layers of the catalyst layers. Here catalyst layer is shown, not shown actually. So one catalyst layer is there around the anode and the cathode. So what happened? These gases should be diffused into that one. At anode catalyst layer, the H2 is splitting up to the four protons and the electrons by losing the electrons of the each molecule. So these electrons can't pass through the fuel cell electrolyte, because the electrolyte material is not permeable to the electrons. It will not allow electron to pass through the electrolyte. So what happens? There's no other option. So it will travel through the external path only. So it will take a path of the external circuit from the anode side to the cathode side to the through the output. So at the same time, the protons migrates through the fuel cell electrolyte from anode to cathode. So at the cathode catalytic layer, the electrons from the external circuit combine with the photons and migrating through the electrolyte plus the oxygen molecule. So what is formed actually? Here H2 is going there, O2 is already there, and electrons will come back from the external circuit. So what happens? There will be a formation of water. So base chemical equation. So definitely during the formation, what happens? Some heat is also be produced. So both will be removed from the gas supply channels actually. That only is written in the next. So this is the normal operation of a fuel cell. Simply the H2 and O2 is reacting off, and then you are getting some electrons, and then you are getting some water and heat. Okay. So what is the difference? What we are going to see in a different cells, fuel cells, is the electrolyte use, major difference. Another one is, instead of here H plus is traveling through the electrolyte, there will be a difference is there. Somewhere we'll get oxygen ions will be traveled, somewhere we'll get hydroxide ions will be traveling, carbonate ions will be migrate through them. So that difference will be there in the different types of fuel cell. Otherwise, same water will be generated, heat will be there, and the electrons will be generated. Only the some materials what we are changing. The concentration will be remain same. You have anode, we have a cathode and electrolyte. That is required. But materials used will be different. So according to the electrolyte types of the different fuel cell, the water and the final electrochemical product can be formed either at the cathode side or the anode side. Yes, that only is written that this depends upon the electrolyte type. So there will be a formation of the different things. The reaction will be different little bit. But basic structure will remain same. Only the materials will be different. So definitely what happens? There will be a different reaction will be taking place. Okay. That's all about the fuel cell. Thank you.